should be recording. Yeah. So what that'll do is obviously come on at that specific time and day. Mm. What it will do, if unless you switch it or change the setting, it will run for 24 hours, then it switch itself off.
Right.
In 7 days' time, if you haven't touched it, it will do exactly the same in seven days' time and run for 24 hours.
Right, okay.
Okay. The next line across, that's all to do with the circulation pump. So you can change the settings on that if you wanted to.
Right.
It's running on the thermostat at the moment.
Mm.
You can have it on continuous if you wanted to.
Right.
Obviously, the problem with it, if you had it on continuous, you might not get the water temperature that you require.
Mm.
Okay, this one here is one of these added extras. It obviously not fitted. You can see if your cylinder's empty or not. Gas cylinder, that is. Next one is to do with
that one there. We haven't got that feature fitted.
No, it's not fitted.
Okay.
That one there is to do with bugs, bacteria in your hot water tank.
Right.
If that is switched on, it will automatically come on at, say, 2 o'clock in the morning, heat up your boiler, so increase the temperature so it'll kill any bacteria like leeching air disease in there.
Okay, right.
This one is a calibration, so obviously it's thermostatically controlled, so you imagine that your room temperature says 30 degrees, and obviously it's a lot colder than that, and you want the heating to come on. Obviously it's not going to come on because it already thinks it's at 30 degrees, so it won't allow it to come on. So what you can do is calibrate the main screen by using that one there to reduce what the temperature actually is in the van.
So hopefully those things you won't need to use.
Yeah, you shouldn't need to, but it's just there. Every time I push the screen, it makes a beep. That one you can actually turn the beep off if you wanted to.
Okay.
Mm. Brightness of your screen.
Right.
If you want to talk French or German to it, you've got that one. That one, as I unlock to get into the screen, you can actually lock it back again if you wanted to there.
Mm.
This one here, external, that's one he's added extras again, obviously not fitted.
Mm.
You can actually use your phone to operate your heating if you wanted to. And the last one there is amps. What it can do is reduce the amount of amps that the boiler uses on electric.
Right.
So if you're on a limited bollard, especially on the continent, you could reduce it doing that if you wanted to.
I see.
But you're better off just going, say, 1 kilowatt on gas rather than messing around with that.
Okay.
And the last screen, service. Obviously, that's for the service guys to check on the boiler, make sure it's obviously for the service time, make sure it's getting up to temperatures and things like that. Reset, obviously if there's any problems you can hit that button and it resets the factory settings. Then translator again for the service guys, they can plug in a computer on the outside and set it up.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So that's all that. Hopefully I haven't confused you with too much information.
Yeah, well we've got quite a thick handbook.
Oh yeah, you've got plenty. If you're struggling to get to sleep, that's quite a good read.
Bedtime reading, yeah.
Okay, your appliances, your fridge.
Yeah.
On off button is there, so you just press and hold to switch it on and off.
Mm.
It's running on gas at the moment.
Mm.
If you want to press it on, put it on electric, just press that.
Mm.
It's now running on electric.
Mm.
That one there is when you're travelling
and
you're connected to your car. Mm. Obviously, it's showing a failure at the moment because it's not connected to the car and the car isn't started.
Mm. Okay, right.
Okay?
Yeah.
If you had a failure like that on the gas side of it,
that
means the gas hasn't lit. So if that's beeping and that's flashing, it means the gas hasn't lit. So obviously, things are check you've got gas or make sure you turn the gas on.
Do people actually run the fridge off gas when they're going along?
You're not supposed to.
I was going to say.
Yeah, you're not supposed to do that.
No. Yeah.
You only set it to the 12 volts, which is your actual vehicle electrics.
Yeah. Okay.
That won't actually cool the fridge down. It will just maintain the temperature of the fridge. You have to cool the fridge down before you travel, before you put it onto that setting.
Okay.
If just going back to the gas, if it does fail on the gas, again check. Obviously check the things, if you've got gas, you turn it on.
Yeah.
Fire up your cooker, make sure you've got gas running. All you do is just press that button there and it reattempts to light it.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
Just put that back on electric. Right. This side of it is your temperature range, which is that button there.
Mm.
All five lit, that's the coldest the fridge is going to be. Mm. Obviously if coming out frozen butter, you might want to reduce it a little bit. It all depends obviously on the temperature outside.
Yeah, okay.
Okay?
This one's got a freezer compartment, hasn't it?
Yeah. So open the door, just press down on that big button at the top.
Right.
You've got your freezer box at the top.
Mm.
This little contraption on the side here, you just push that against the wall and pull it out.
Mm.
What that actually does is, when you're not using it, it holds the door slightly.
It used to have a little thing at the top.
That little tab
that gets
knocked about. So obviously, it's working actually on the door mechanism itself, so obviously push that down.
Yeah.
And make sure that is fully back when you want to use it.
Yeah,
if you don't,
the
fridge won't seal and you'll think the fridge is not working. Okay? On and off, just press and hold that button.
Okay.
Okay?
Right, that sounds
fine. While we're down here, we've got individual appliance gas taps.
Mm.
You've got a little info note there to tell you what they're connected to.
Mm.
Okay, you don't need to turn them on or off. Obviously, the main one is your gas cylinder itself.
Mm. So they're all turned on at the moment?
Yeah, they're all turned on. You don't need to switch them on or off. If it comes in for service, obviously, they check it.
Yeah.
Checking individual appliances, they may forget to switch them back on.
Yeah.
So if you're trying to light your cooker or whatever and it's not lighting, just have a check in there just to make sure it is in the correct position. Yeah. Your little info note there will show you what position they need to be
in. Right, okay, to be that's on. It. Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Cooker, it's got 12 volt igniter there. So you just you probably had that on your previous one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, now it's also got a safety cutout
on there.
So yeah, if it's not lighting, just make sure that it's fully back.
Mm.
Your grill. Your grill handles, pan handles inside there.
Okay, fine.
And your oven.
Yeah, I can see it's on. There's a little burners on at the back. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, fine.
Right, microwave. Big button press opens the microwave.
Yeah.
Flash plate, don't travel with that in there, because if that drops out on here, it's going to be expensive.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, right.
So we sneak it under the seat now, obviously it's clean.
Mm.
Or my wife tends to put it in the bowl with a tea towel wrapped around it or whatever.
Okay, there was one in a cupboard when we looked.
Yeah.
Was it? Yeah, it was in that cupboard. Okay. The once one, it was like a, you know, put in plate.
It's the same there as well, if you had it in there and it rolled out.
Yeah,
bounced around a bit.
Mm.
Okay, to operate your microwave, you can see that control there doing absolutely nothing.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay, for that to work, you have to press one of these buttons.
Mm.
So, if you press the microwave button once, that gets the power, so 100%, 50%, or whatever you want to set it. If you press the microwave button again, then you turn that, it gives you your seconds then.
Okay,
and then you can press start and away it goes.
Mm.
Quick on the start button as well, there's also a quick start which goes up in minute increments and starts automatically.
Mm.
Okay.
Right. Yes, okay. That sounds
But it's just one of them things, it's like, well, why doesn't that just why doesn't it just give a second straight away and you have to mess around with it?
Mm. Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Inside here, you've got a solar panel on the roof.
Right.
This is a regulator for it. You don't have to switch it on and off. It's all totally automatic.
Right.
Okay, the top light is green at the moment.
Yeah.
That's showing that it's giving you around about 12.5 volts at the moment.
Right.
So the battery's in reasonable condition.
Yeah.
If it turns, the top light turns red, that means obviously the battery's in worse condition and it's giving it the full 14.5 volts it can give.
Right.
The bottom light flashing is the green flashing light. That's to say it is charging.
Right.
There will be occasions when the lights will totally go out. Obviously, one, it's dark.
Mm.
Obviously, it's not going to do much in the dark unless it's a really bright moon.
No.
The battery is fully discharged, so it actually switches off them two little lights to actually save energy to go towards the battery. And obviously, if it's fully charged as well, it'll shut the lights off.
Okay, so we don't need to worry about that at all.
No, it's totally automatic. It does. Okay. Obviously, senses a drop in the battery, off it goes.
That's really so that, say, if you've got your alarm on, you leave the caravan for a month or whatever.
Yeah.
What you lose powering this is going to be put back into the battery.
It's trickling in there, Okay.
Yeah,
okay. So, you've got your bathroom, probably civic, so obviously what your bathroom is. Electric flush.
Yeah.
Indicates to say if your waste tank's full.
Yeah.
Obviously,
we didn't have one of those.
Radiator.
No, we didn't.
It has got a bleed there, so it's very similar to your domestic radiator. If you just cold at the top, hot at the bottom.
Has it actually just got water in it?
No, it hasn't. No, it's got antifreeze. So if you do attempt to bleed it, make sure you've got a cloth or something over the top of it. You don't want antifreeze down yourself or down down the wall.
No, okay.
Mm. Okay.
Mm.
All right. So if you have to allow fluid out there, do you have to put it in anywhere? Or is it, there's a header tank.
Yeah, there is. Which is hiding inside here.
Right.
So this here is your expansion tank.
Right.
Okay, when you start when it's cold, make sure it's at least a finger's width above minimum.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, as it warms, it will expand into expands into there. You can top it up if you need to by taking this cover off here and unscrewing the pump out the top.
It's a bit like a cooling system on a car, basically.
Yeah, it is, more or less.
Yeah.
But the only thing you've got to be careful of is if you are going to top it up, make sure you're putting the right mix in. So we've had some customer that's put the wrong stuff in and it's gone all...
Well, he'll tell us in the handbook what to get.
We
best get a small amount, I guess, because we need it.
They're not too bad, as far as I'm aware.
Mm.
You don't tend to top up too much. Your directional aerial,
which
is sitting here, and obviously you've got your amplifier there.
Mm.
If you had this type of directional aerial before, there is a little indicator on it to say if it's horizontal or vertical on top of the aerial.
Okay.
So obviously H for horizontal.
Right.
And then obviously push it up. If you wind that handle,
okay,
turn it to vertical. So obviously make sure it's in the green before you bring it back down.
Yeah.
It says on here the indicator, then also the rear of the antenna.
Okay.
On your note. And make sure obviously it's down and
fastened properly.
And fastened before you travel.
Right, okay. So you've got a backlit mirror, which is quite handy.
Yeah, so your light switch is
big.
Just here.
You've got a light in the shower as well, so
you
can
put it right
in there.
Quite tidy. Mm-hmm. Your
got the Campbell shower head.
Yeah,
that's the table.
Yeah, so your table storage out. Obviously, make sure that's secure before you travel. Mm-hmm. You don't want that bouncing out.
No, causing
a lot of damage.
No.
Okay, there is a little plastic. If you see there, a little plastic retainer thing that stops it.
Oh yes, I see.
Tipping,
yeah. Okay.
So make sure that is secure before you. Travel.
Self-expansion.
Yeah. Then just above our heads. Obviously, I'll just switch the heating down. Obviously, I put it flat out to get the pump. The pump to.
Switch
back. So electronic fan, switch it on, just press the, where the on off button is there. You can open the vent there.
Right, okay.
So you make sure it is shut before you travel.
So what is this doing? It's sucking it out?
At the moment, yeah, it's sucking it out. Yeah. So you see that little icon there, it's got a little vehicle with an arrow pointed out. So if you press that, that actually speeds it up.
Oh, I see.
Okay? If you want to slow it back down again, press the opposite one, and that will slow it back down again. Okay?
Right, so this will only pull the air out?
No, it will come in as well. If you look at that little icon there,
that's the end.
Yeah, so you can actually.
Okay, you can do it the other way.
You actually pull air in. So it, again, use the opposite icon to slow it back down again. Obviously, I've got the vent, obviously, vent shut at the moment. But.
It felt as though it was going the other way then, when this was on.
That's it, you have to wait to. That's it. Wait to slow it in.
That's going out.
Obviously, you open the vent, obviously, it was pushing it back down again. But
yeah,
I'm just switching it off. Okay. But you make sure that is secure before you, before you travel.
Okay, fine.
Right.
I think that's
everything. Your handbook, which is also your warranty book as well.
Right.
Okay, I just need you to, if you can just sign date, and if you could just print there as well for us. Obviously, it has got a tracker fitted. Which you need to go back to Stuart and he'll set that up for
What's
you.
What's the date today?
It's
the third. What did you want me to do?
Yeah, if you just print
Armor or something.
Well, it is, because obviously the top two copies go to service and then obviously they store it and then they struggle to read the signature somewhere.
Yeah.
You keep all that and give that to Stuart when you go back to him.
Right.
And if you know about what the tracker does or how it works.
Well, I know what he's supposed to do. I don't really know how it works.
What happens is you ring up the police because it doesn't tell you that your caravan's been stolen. You have to obviously notice your caravan's been stolen.
Oh, and tell the police.
So you ring the police, they give you an instant number, and then you call tracker, and then they switch the tracker system on, and then the police can track the caravan then.
Okay, so this is going to have a chassis number, right, or something, or is this?
No, I think it's that there.
Oh, that's the chassis number.
Yeah.
So, okay, vehicle registration number, is that the...
Yeah, that's if it was a car.
Yeah. Okay. I had one on a car before, and they used to ring me up and say your car's moved, and I said yes, it's in the garage. So they could literally tell where you'd move from one service bay to the other inside the garage. Incredible.
Yeah, is that accurate? Yeah. Yeah. Right, inside your drawer, is that one? That's that one. Obviously, all your information. That's your handbook as well, which you've got the information on.
Okay.
The only wheel that torque settings, obviously, you've got that on the panel as well.
Right.
That little brass one there, that's for your gas barbecue.
Right.
And this one here, that with your 13-pin connection.
Mm.
When you sometimes, if you don't turn it enough when you're pulling it back out of the car socket, it can slightly unalign it. So this contraption here, it's just a bit of plastic, it can actually reline it back up again. Because if you don't, it can't get it back in the car socket.
I've never used a 13-pin before.
No.
So, but I'm having a tow bar fitted in about a week's time. So,
yeah. Just are they aware that it is being connected to a caravan?
Yes. It's a 13-pin.
Yeah. But sometimes they don't connect. Certain like power for the electrics for your fridge and your ATC, which is on the same line as well. So just make them aware that it is for a caravan. Otherwise, you'll see that the ATC is obviously the important one.
Yes. Okay. Right. Okay. Well, I thought I just didn't realise I just said 13-pin. It's a having a Witter bar.
Yeah.
And it's a BMW, so we're having one that plugs into the wiring loom.
Right.
Rather than so they don't have to mess around with the wiring.
Yeah. Right.
Okay.
Right. What we've got here is your handover sheet. So this is just want you to go through this. I'm disconnecting things on the outside.
Right. Okay.
So if you can go through that now, ticking each one as you're going along.
Yeah.
Most of the things should be okay.
Show